Hello friends and students, welcome back to my session on Arduino in 21 days. We are on day 9. Today we will see about a all-in-one analog value ultrasonic button switch with LCD program. Okay, this is the program. Actually we are in day 9. I'll be combining the day 6, day 7 and day 8 programs together, and on today the day 9 we'll be seeing that. Let me show you the day 6 program. In that we used two switches. I used a permanent switch on and switch off button, you know. So those two switches, if switch one is on, that time we saw switch one pressed M. Senthil Kumar. I copied this one, okay, and pasted here. That's it. I copied this one and pasted here. Instead of switch one pressed and M. Senthil Kumar, I put M. Senthil Kumar has made it, because it is my own program. That is one change I made it as far as the display is concerned. Then in the if statement, I put an exclusive if. Actually, what is exclusive if? If both switch one and switch two are low, both switch one and switch two are not pressed, if it is not on. Not pressed, low, off, all are same. Okay, then only this will be executed. Okay, that means now let me show you the thing. Before that, let me tell you one thing. The program sequence: switch one, switch two, low, low. That means action 1, and low high action 2, high high action 3, high low action 4, action or activity, whatever it be. Okay, so using this switch 1 and switch 2, you'll get 4 possible combinations. If both switch 1 and switch 2 are off, then we can set one action. If one is low, 2 is high, action 2. 1 and 2 both are high, action 3. 1 is high, 2 is low, action 4. That is what we will be seeing. Okay, so here both are low, switch 1 low, switch 2 low, 1 action. Switch 1 high, switch 2 low, second action. In the meantime, this will be executed whatever be the condition. Then both are high, one action. Under the both of high, I included the sensor, the analog value finding with the help of a 10k variable resistor, right? So it takes the reading from here, it will be displayed here. Then if one is low, two is high. Here I included the ultrasonic sensor module, display this ultrasonic activity here. So this will be activated, this will be in action, this will be on only when switch 1 is off, switch 2 is on. Over and above all these things, I included another LED1 output pin, LED1 output pin assigned to D4. The LED pin is an output. Okay, so irrespective of that, whatever be the condition, whether both are low or both are high, one is high, one is low, this will be in action. The if the map value is greater than 40, what is the range of map value? You have to see the map value range is 1 to 101. Okay, so if it is moving beyond 40, then the digital write LED is high, otherwise else. digital write LED one is low. So this is how I wrote a program. I could say it is my own program, of course. Okay, previously so let me tell you, from the day 6 I copied this block. I copied Control C and put Control V inside that. I close it. The day 7 we saw about the analog value finding, okay, by varying the resistor. We saw the actual resistance value. It is a 10 bit 0 to 1023, okay, and also the mapped one 0 to 101. I copied this one, I included that also, closed. Then yesterday day 8 we used ultrasonic sensor, okay. So that thing I copied from here, I copied this one, I pasted here. Where is it? Yeah, I pasted here. You see the distance time equal to 340 meter per second, you know. So the conversions and all we made, okay. So I included here. So let me close this one also. Okay, this is a program. Again I repeat the program. The liquid crystal display I2C module I used A1 A2 for the ultrasonic sensor, the trigger and echo. Time on and distance are the float variable for the ultrasonic sensor. Switch on and switch to, getting these four combinations: low low, low high, high high, high low. These two are the switches. I introduce another LED that will be displayed. For that a small LED I put here. You can show that, you can see that here. Yeah, so let me zoom it. So this is my laptop, I'm sitting here. So we see here, yeah, D2 is connected with this switch. You can see here D2 switch 1, D2 connected here. This is the switch 1. The switch 2 is connected to D3. So switch 2 is connected to D3. The LED 1 is connected to 4. So one leg you see plus, the longer pin is plus, shorter pin in the LED is minus. So it is D4 and it is grounded other end. Okay, then this resistor, this is for the analog value finding variable, 10k variable resistor. The left one grounded, right one 5 volt, the midpoint. So this is the connection actually connected to A0. Then A1, A2. Now A0 is used for the analog value. You can see here, you see sensor pin A0. Okay, then A1, A2 used to for the ultrasonic sensor. So this is ultrasonic sensor. There are 4 pins. One is the leftmost is 5 volt. The rightmost is the ground. The in between is the A1 and A2. So everything is connected. And A3, A4 connected to I2C. So this is the I2C wire connected. Okay, so these are the things. In the setup block, LCD should be initialized. Then you have to configure the digital and analog pins, whether it is input or output. So everything is done here. Let us see that loop block. Just before I said, again I'll be repeating, there are 4 possibilities: low low. These are the 4 policies. Now in between we'll see the connection. So this file is available with you as PDF file. So this is the nano board, LCD, I2C module, how to connect the I2C, it is given here. Then this time I use the buttons also, button 1 and button 2, button 2 D2, button 2 D3. Then variable resistor connected to A0 pin, mid pin is A0 pin. Then this is the ultrasonic sensor, VCC, trigger is connected to A1, echo is connected to A2, this is ground 0 volt. Analog 2 power 10, so 1024 division, so 0 to 23, and it's also mapped. Now this we saw it already. Now we see about this thing in the with the help of the program. So if both are low, this if statement will be executed. Okay, M.Sethil Kumar has made it. Okay, then if switch 1 on but switch 2 off, that means that time this LCD display, you will get it. MSK is now ready for industry 4.0. So that value will be getting. Then if both are high, that is a third possibility. If both are high, this variable resistor will work. Variable resistor will work. At the same time, this also will work. If MAP value is greater than 40, then LED bulb will go. Both will be an action. Not only in this particular thing, it is throughout. Whether both are on, both are off, one is off, doesn't matter. So this will be in effect. The LED pin will be on if it is, if MAP value is greater than 40. If not, LED is off. Okay, now we see all these things one by. And then the last combination is switch 1 low, switch 2 high. So the distance ultrasonic system will be in effect. So but in practice all will be working actually, but in the display you will be seeing all these things here, but all will be running in the background. Okay, now shall we see it in action? Okay, so I programmed it. Then let me play the video. Okay, so now I am about to press this button. Both are off. Let me go back. So this is the LED, switch 1, LED, new LED I inserted. This is the switch 2. Now both are off actually. When both are off, the Senthil Kumar, M. Senthil Kumar has made it. That is this one. Loop. If both switch 1 and switch 2 are low, M. Senthil Kumar has made it. Okay, that display you will be getting. Then we will see the next one. What is the next one? I will be pressing switch 1 now. So switch 1 is high, switch 2 is low. So MSK is now ready for industry 4.0. So we will see that. Let me play again. Now I am about to press switch 1. Now I pressed. Yeah, let me pause the video. So MSK is now ready for industry 4.0. So this block invoked actually, right? Now we'll see the next one, the third combination. Both are high. Already switch 1 is on. Now let me switch on the switch 2. Now switch 2 is on. Let me go back slightly. Okay, at the same time, this is a variable resistor. I have to adjust it using the screwdriver. Now you see, now I'll be tilting the using the screwdriver. I'm about to, yeah. I'm about to tilt. Okay, tilting is happening simultaneously. You see only the display. So I'm tilting actually. So display is varying. I pass this one. If both are high, then the actual value, sensor value, mapped value between, this will be 0 to 1023. This is 1 to 101 mapped value. These displays alone you will be seeing. Once this 25, this value is greater than 40, greater than or equal to 40, you see greater than 40. I just go back. Now it is greater than 40. Now LED is glowing. Let me reduce once again. Now it is less than 40. LED is off. Okay. So that's it. Then we'll see the last block, the distance measuring. Okay. I'll show you that one also. For that, switch 1 must be off. So, yeah, I switched off the switch 1. Okay, now echo is on. Let me use the obstruction. Now you see the distance. Now I am moving the plate. Okay, so distance will be varying. distance will be varying. Okay, so a single program, first time we'll be combining all the some of the parameters actually. So that means we are slowly building a project, right? So like that, depending upon the setup, you have to write a program. Mostly I'll be using if statement only, even with the help of if and maybe switch statement. These two are sufficient to write hundreds of programs actually. Okay, so you see that this is the AND statement. If this AND statement, if both are true, then only it is actuated. But suppose if your requirement is R, I think R, there will be a separate button. I think OR is the key, I think so. Okay, so now parallel switch, I think. Okay, I'll tell you later. Okay, so AND statement is very, very important here. So that means the if conditional statement is specific. Okay, so I copied this program in this particular word file. I'll convert this as a PDF and I'll attach it in the link actually. Okay, so let me copy this video also. This video also, this image also. Okay, so this is the program. You can just copy the program and you can run it. Okay, again it repeats. You may have to include the libraries for the wire hedge and liquid crystals. Probably it would have been installed already. If it is installed, no problem. Okay, you will not get any error message. If it is not installed, you will get error message here while verifying or while compiling it. So that means you have to include the library. Search in it, you will get it. Okay, so manage library or add zip library, go any mode. You can download the necessary library files required for this particular program. Especially these two header files as library file are required actually. Okay, then next thing is to fuse it in the board. You see that whether you are using the Arduino Nano, either Atmega 328P or Atmega old bootloader or Atmega 168, then port is very important. Already I am using two ports for some other purpose, so you will get a new port number the moment you insert the USB cable with the laptop. Okay, so that number should be configured. Then if you press this button, upload button, this program will be fused. Okay, so that is the end of it. Hope you have understood all-in-one program, finding analog value, ultrasonic button, and assigning two different display activities using the button switches 1 and 2 simultaneously from the analog value, switching on LED. Okay, let me tell you one more thing. See, in this I'll go back to the now. What I can tell you do is you do it on your own. I used only as far as digital pins are concerned, D2, D3, D4 alone I used, D5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and this 13. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 switches I haven't used. If you want, have 9 more LEDs, small LEDs like this. In the program, you can type map value double if statement. This will not be included in this program, in the AND. Let me copy this one. Less than or equal to, now I put 100 actually, there is no meaning actually. Okay, what you can do is LED1, LED2, LED3, 9 more pins are there, you know, 9 more ports are there, you know, in the Arduino. So LED1, 2, 3, 4, up to 9 you can have. Okay, so map value between 1 to 10, LED1 on, 11 to 20, LED2 on, 21 to 30, LED3 on, and so on. Like that, you can write a program. Like that, you can write a program. Okay, let me copy this one. Yeah, I can change only this one, right? Okay. So you can keep on adding. So this statement alone is added, but suppose say between greater than 1, less than 10, LED2 is on, otherwise LED2 is off. But LED2, you have to assign it here. You have to assign here LED2 port number 5, pin number 5, then LED2 output in the setup. All these things you have to do it. Right? So let me erase this one. Let me verify whether it is working or not. Yeah, without any error. Now for purposely I'm introducing error. Okay, let me delete this semicolon. Now let me compile. Now it shows error, expected semicolon before token, some message it comes, right? Let me introduce a semicolon, recompile, no error. So compiling done. Okay, so that is for today's thing. So today, in my view, it is a very important day for me and for me all, for you also even, because we have done a program on our own, I could say. Okay, so using if statement, we used five different activities. Okay, what are the five different activities? This four combination plus LED glowing. Okay, so thank you so much. If you like my channel, you please subscribe my channel and inform this to others, so let them also learn from my session. It is my small initiative. Actually, again and again I am telling you, I am not an expert in Arduino actually, but the thing that I learned on my own, there is no teacher for me, I learned it on my own actually. I developed so far in a matter of 7 months only I learned this. So I developed nearly 20 different projects actually, even industry level projects also I done through Arduino. So I just we are in lockdown period, I just wanted to share my experience and my ideas. I don't want to be idle, so I organized this session. Okay, so subscribe my channel and inform this to others also, let them also get some benefit. Okay, thank you.